back. CiCi Games is playing Final Fantasy IX. We are continuing on playing the game from where we left off, which, if you can see, I haven't paused. I just unpaused it where I was saving, and I'm about to make sure that I start up the Magnet quest as well. So begins. Oh, that actually looks amazing.
Thank you.
Okay, so I messed up twice. So I would have had a score of 71. No, I messed up three times, so 72. Okay, let's try this again. Are wet. I'll gallop. So before we continue on with the recon, we're going to go back into here. If I'm not mistaken, there should have been a mock or something in here, I thought. I could have sworn there was a mock. Okay, so I don't get the mog doesn't show up until later. Okay. So we're gonna head up the stairs and we'll run into the lovely Princess Garnet Tis Alexandros. So what I love, the fact, is that the robe that she's wearing is actually an Easter egg of small sorts of what the traditional white mages wore in Final Fantasy. It's like a nice little touch for Final Fantasy fans. Zorn and Thorn are funny. I do like them. I also like their theme music that they have for Zorn and Thorn. Steiner.
Thank you.
finished our mod. So we'll go ahead and do another save. Because it's always better to save your game at regular intervals. So he doesn't have any mail for us. Like a small little mini game with these later on. So, Horst Steiner, Blitzen, Cole, Lotto, Doschborn, Berdick, Weimer, Hagen, and even Mullenkindheim. Good lord, where did they find all those names? Okay, so we're done in here for now. We're gonna go back up. We're gonna go back out here. So, there's our moonstone. That is what we got as a result of getting the 100 nobles from the minigame with Zidane and Blank. Or if you want to know the Japanese version of that, it should be Gohaku, if I'm not mistaken. It's Gohaku. Those are the female soldiers, so they're under Beatrix. Our blue mage that we'll eventually have in our party. Because I don't do well with speed plays, I'm probably not going to be able to go for the Excalibur playthrough. I enjoy being able to level up my characters pretty high, and then there's a secret down in there for us to get later on. It's also where, when we have a boat, we will be able to dock it there.
Thank you.
Apologies. There we go. We're back. Was drawn the way she was. Then again, I didn't understand why some of the characters were drawn the way they were. I would love to see this remade. Not just remastered, but remade. I think this, not even really remade, but I would love to see this game with voice acting. To hear the inflection of the voice and everything, instead of just reading it. Because in my mind, like, she's probably, I kind of picture Claire Holt's voice. When Garnett talks, so first thing we're gonna do, of course, again, we're going to see if Steiner has any items for us to steal. Yet again. So Marcus and Zidane, their first object is to steal from. Oh, we can't steal. Back in 1995 through 97 when it was being developing everything. But this came out in the early, right at 1999, 2000s era, maybe even somewhere right in there. And you know, it was right on the edge of it going to PS2. So the graphics capability and the technology was getting better to where even with the PS1 and its system requirements and everything, they could go beyond that. Continue the stream here. Have her in my head as her voice. I kind of think Queen Braun's voice Angelina Jolie from Maleficent. That kind of voice style would be who I think of Queen Braun as. Now, this is just my opinion, by the way, so, like, Claire Holt for Garnett and Angelina Jolie for Queen Braun. If I had to choose the Danes, he's more of like a country, like a bandit and very country-esque. Maybe like in his head, maybe I'm picturing I still kind of think he should be British. Maybe, and trust me, I'm probably on a British kick lately, so that might be why, but, I'm thinking, James McAvoy, maybe. Keeper. Sec, I'm having to do some work here. So, we do have a Mog here. Let's go and talk to our Mog friend. We are going to... First thing we'll do is we will save the... So, I am saving. Give me just a second. And we're back. Second thing we'll do is we will ask him about Mognet. He does not have any mail, nor is he one of the characters that we can get mail from. There is a Phoenix down at there. Talk to Sin again. Alright, so first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna walk. Come down here. So, we do have the opportunity to do a slight bit of leveling up if we wanted to. I am going to go ahead and look and see what all Zidane has ability-wise. This is a good time to look and see what he is learning from what items he has equipped. So protect girls, so essentially this is your cover, except it's only going to be for the girls. So from the party members that you can get, that would be Kina, our blue mage, Aiko, who is another white mage, Garnet or Dagger, as she will be called, as another white mage, and then you have I can't remember her actual name. Our character, our Dragoon Knight, basically from Celera. I cannot remember her name. I think think I named her Freya. Last time I played, I've named her Freya. That I actually don't know if that is true. Her true name. So, but our Celera Knight, Celera Dragoon Knight, she would also fall under this protect role. So this is recover, flee minus skill. I would suggest this if you are doing the 12-hour Excalibur run, so that you could flee battles without having to lose skill. So those are the two items he is learning from his equipment right now. I hit square, by the way, if you want to know a quick way to get from your ability list to your equipment list, so you can look and see what he's learning. So the difference between, and this isn't a tutorial, but I'll go ahead and kind of explain it to you. If it's a red with an A on it in your list, that is an active ability. So he's going to be learning flee. A leather hat does nothing for him. So if it's essentially, if it's a blank item with an S on it, that means it's a support skill. That means it's passive, meaning it has to be equipped for it to do anything, for you to be able to use it. So this is the flea minus skill, and then you got protect girls. And all of this is AP. When you get from a battle, it's AP. Goes towards learning these skills. These are accessories, so we do have the Moonstone already, so he could already learn Beast Killer, so that is actually a really good idea for him to learn. We will be fighting a lot of plants and beasts in this area. So Mage Masher is actually better because he learns Flee and Detect, so we are going to go ahead and equip that to him. Have wrist, leather, silk shirt does not need to go towards him. That needs to go towards either Vivi or even Garnet, having that equipped to them, because it's going to teach Cure and Thunder. Vivi, Thunder, Ico, or Dagger will learn Cure. Now, Dagger already knows Cure, so this isn't, other than a defense increase, this will not help her at the current point in time, but it will help Vivi to learn Thunder ahead of time. Let's see, do we have anything? Okay, we only have a leather hat. So, that's a quick rundown on that. We are going to go ahead and equip Vivi's Killer, and my skill, there's nothing else. We're good for right now. So, we can either, we could run around in here. Maybe not right this second. Yeah, it doesn't look like right this second where you're gonna hit any encounters. That is the first area that you can really kind of run into for encounters. And do a small amount of grinding. So. Bad idea on my part, using an area of effect. So this is why we saved before going there. So we'll go ahead and we'll do a load game. We'll load my game back up. Lesson learned, people, do not use Tidal Flame. So I will go ahead and get my stuff re-equipped. I'm not redoing the tutorial, by the way. You can either rewind and watch it again, or what have you. But remember, I did equip two supportive abilities. I equipped Beast Killer, and I did Flee-Minus Skill. So now we are... Actually, I do want to do one other thing. So the episode... Our little stream is starting to go a little long. I've still got a little bit more stuff to do, though. Let's go to our config really quick. I'm gonna see if... Let's make it active. Oh, here we go. Yeah, we'll go. Okay, so that should help me with the battle speed. I'm also gonna have to definitely make sure that paying attention now since I turned it to active instead of a wait. If you ever are curious, wait is more, if you like to really plan what you're going to be doing, wait is for you. If you like more of a fast-paced battle and you can make decisions on the fly and still come out on top, active is going to be the way to go. Now, you can still be on an active system and you can slow the battle down for the field message and the battle speed. However, I sped mine up. I did just recently come off of playing Final Fantasy VII, and I did get kind of addicted to the speed boost. So I am going to say that the active ATB system is very, very, very slow for me. So, it's speeding up the battle is helping me a lot, probably going to help me a lot, because I did get so used to having to make decisions in an active time settings with 3x speed on. That's not fault for my own. Possibility that I need to just say that There we go. Okay, so continue does allow us to do this, so that's good. My last quick save data, I guess. So let's see if I can actually manage to. So we confirmed that it didn't have any hidden edits. To pause it for a moment, I'm going to make myself a little treat.
Okay.
definitely know this one. He's actually a good, an amazing voice actor. Not just a good one, but an amazing one. Possibly as Vivi. So I've said Crane Braun, I've said Zidane, I've said Vivi, and I've said Garnet. So, of the next of the main party, who should I... Let's see. Thank you. Steiner's voice. Honestly, I kind of hear Hugh Laurie, kind of a cynic, or even better, probably be Jeremy Irons. Either Hugh Laurie or Jeremy Irons, I would love to hear a Steiner. I know that is a long shot for Square Enix to ever get them, but that's kind of who I hear in my head when I think of like their actual voices. Okay, so let's see if we can find any goodies. That one's referencing. So, bronze gloves. Just kind of make sure you turn every which way you can. So, we do have an active time event. So, you have time to escape and the girl who was left behind. It's up to you. I don't think there's really one either way that you need to choose, and I think you might be able to choose both, so we're gonna do time to escape. The obvious chest. Go up on top of the bunk here in the corner. Thank you. Before we go and talk to the boss, we're gonna see if we can find any secrets. Like a rubber helm. So we've found quite a few things for Steiner, and are looking around here. Got another obvious chest with a leather hat. I think that's all that we can get right this second. So we're gonna go all the way up to the top and talk with Baku again. We're not going to talk to Baku right away. Let's go in here. That's where he was.
Thank you.
So we need to go back in there because there are a couple of little trinkets and treasures we can get. Even if it's just one from that. Just kind of make sure you kind of look at the sides. There we go. So let's go and talk to Vivi. Since we have our characters in hand now, we're gonna go ahead. So, let's see what all. So, bug killer. Antibody is actually really good to learn. That is a poison and venom. State supportability. To stave it off, so it's essentially, if you think about it from Final Fantasy VII, it is our star pendant to ward off poison or venom attacks. I am going to keep his current equipment on. This is because I do want him to learn Beast Killer, I want him to learn Bug Killer, and I want him to learn Bird Killer. I've already looked at him. So, a mage staff, we're learning fire. That's good. Leather hat, we're learning fire. A wrist, a leather wrist right there. Blizzard. Silk shirt, learning thunder. So, this is the stuff that we found is really good for Vivi. So, we're gonna go ahead and go back to Steiner. Make sure you hit cancel to get to the first part. We may have some birds, we may have some bugs, probably have some beasts, and we have enough left over for antibody, so that's good. And then Vivi doesn't have any supportive abilities to learn yet. That's okay. He is also in our back row, so that's even better. So let's continue on. Honestly, I think we'll be okay on that. We're gonna go ahead and do another save, and I will be signing off after the save. Okay, sorry, one second. I think I hit cancel instead of save. This is what happens when you don't pay attention to what you're doing. Yeah, I did. I hit cancel. I didn't save. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, all YouTubers, I am signing off for the night. We shall pick up with part 3 tomorrow or the next day. Have a good evening. Leave a like, comment, and subscribe.